My name is Lina Schulze-Buxloh. I'm from the FH Aachen University of Applied Sciences in Germany. And as already mentioned, today I'm going to present our paper titled Digital Planning Using Building Information Modeling and Virtual Reality, a new approach for students' remote practical training under lockdown conditions in the course of smart building engineering. So first of all, I give a short introduction why we came across this idea. First, we had to deal with the situation that students in the higher semesters of the course Smart Building Engineering in 2020 had a practical training intended to get some contact to industry and to gain first practical experience and routine in daily working life. But we came across the problem because of Corona pandemic that we had a lot of restrictions like social distancing, and many students were afraid of a delay in graduation. So we came across the idea that we definitely need a new approach to get this problem solved. And so we had to develop a new concept. Of course, it had to be suitable to lockdown restrictions in Germany. So we had to avoid physical contacts between the students. Unfortunately, we had only online lectures allowed. So there was hardly any students contact at university allowed. We had social distancing, and therefore we had to find a possibility that all students are able to work on the project from home or from anywhere where they are. So we also had the idea that we would like to give these students a real problem rather than another sample project or another example to work on. So we defined a new task. We had some unused rooms at the university that should be digitally recorded in order to develop a new usage concept as practical training and laboratory rooms. An inventory of the actual state of the rooms was done by us, first by taking photos and listing up all floors and specialties of the rooms. The goal we would like to come through was that we would like them to use the software for planning technical building services, also supporting building information modeling, which is a quite important part in this course. And it should be used for the creation of a 3D model in which the complete technical design of all components needed was implemented. So in order to better illustrate the difference between the actual state and the target state, two virtual reality models were created so that the difference can also be more or less experienced with virtual reality glasses. Here you can see the old plans of the rooms I talked about. In the left, you see the ground floor. So you see these are four rooms being connected to each other. And you see some stairs going downstairs. And then we come to the right, you see the same rooms in the cellar, they have again five rooms. So it's a quite big lab. Here you can see some photos of the actual condition at the beginning. Left side is the ground floor. You see we definitely have to tidy it up, and you see a more or less unused cellar on the right. These rooms haven't been used for any practical course or anything like that for many years, and have just been used more or less as some kind of storage. So, of course, we had to make up our mind which aspects the students should deal with. At first, we wanted them to go through all entire digital planning phases using this BIM technique. Then, of course, they had to deal with technical specifications. Of course, everything had to be documented. They should do a cost estimation, some kind of time planning, and at the end, a 3D visualization in virtual reality. Here you can see a short overview over the workflow we used. We used from the Leica company a 3D laser scanner to scan all the rooms. Here, these red dots you see, these are the positions where we put the laser scanner through these rooms. That's used to create a so-called point cloud. Then we imported the data into Revit. And then later on, we created the 3D modeling in virtual reality. To get you a more detailed overview about the used software, I'll just give you this short overview. First, we start with the Leica BLK 360 Manager, a software that is included by the company. It's used for data acquisition and processing. In the next step, we change to Cyclone Register. This is the software we use to create the point cloud. So it's combining all the photographies the camera and the scanner is going to pick up. Then the data is transferred to a so-called software recap. This is for clearing the point cloud to get rid of all those information you do not really need. Then we switched again to Autodesk Revit for 3D modeling and planning. There we also had some plugins, for example, Kaneko BIM and Kaneko BT, which is used for example, for electrical planning. And then as both models, the actual state and the target state were finished in Revit, we used for rendering and for the virtual model, the software Enscape. Here you can see some pictures from in between. So you see on the left side, this little pointy picture is a combination of lots of photos taken by the laser scanner and then combined to a 3D point cloud. And later on the right side, you see the digital 3D model in Revit you get from this room, just to show you the workflow. In the next step, you have point clouds for all rooms, and then you can merge them up to all the individual rooms into floors. As you see here, and the left side again, you see the point cloud data built up into floors. And on the right side, you see the 3D planning model created by this data. And of course, cleared up. If you finished measuring and combining all rooms to two floors, you get this 3D model of the target state where all the technical planning and everything is already inside. I hope you can see it. It might be a little too small. And here I would like to give you some idea about the change you can see in VR. Of course, now I had to take some screenshots to be able to present it to you, but I think it's good enough for you to get an impression what we did and how big the change is. This is on the ground floor, one of these working areas in the actual state. Here you see the stairs going down in this kind of cage that no one is falling down. Later on the target state, the stairs have disappeared. This door on the left is easy to be opened, and you see you have a little bit more space. It's a better structure. Another example in the cellar. First, you had lots of doors and not much space to move. Later on here, you see you have, for example, emergency exits. You have some space for storage. You have new pipings. And you also have, for example, here some signals that you can see, am I allowed to enter this room while an experiment, for example, is running that might be dangerous or better not. So you also see here quite a big change. This was one of the storage rooms in the cellar, just storing some stuff no one really needs anymore. This one would be our plan. You see much more technical device, everything tidied up so you can really use it as a lab for doing some tests. And here we had another room where, for example, here you see this ladder and this door. We had some specialties in this room because here's a connection to a former bunker in the cellar. Of course, we were not allowed to change that, but also here, same again, we changed all these storage stuff into a place where you really can work doing some experiment and really use it. So the conclusion of this project from our side was very nice because the students definitely gave us lots of positive feedback. For us, it turned out to be an excellent alternative to on-site practical training, especially under these special lockdown conditions. Many students told us in the end that their motivation increased much to deal with complex technical questions by really doing something on their own and really dealing with a real problem and not another example problem. And of course, many of the students who took part in preferred dealing with typical problems. They might occur on their daily working routine as well during planning and construction process, instead of simply listening to another online lecture or even having to wait for lockdown to end. So all in all, we had to plan and set everything up quite in a hurry, but in the end, we were all quite happy about the result, and we will definitely, at least take into account this good experience for future actions, no matter if pandemic is going on or maybe hopefully ending one day. So thanks a lot for your attention. And of course, you are welcome to ask some questions.